welcome, welcome, my brave viewers. Welcome to the Royal Complex Grounds for today's match. My name is Paul Foy, and I'll be taking you through the introduction for the second semi final of the 2016 Under 20 Milo President's Trophy match between St Thomas's College and the Royal College. We'll see who'll be joining Izzy Pantana College in the big dance. The final next week will be played at this venue next Saturday. We'll hand over to Sharnika, who's down at the sideline with the captains at the moment. Are you there, Sharnika? Hello, Sharnika.
Hello and welcome to the Milo President's Trophy second semi-final live broadcast here on Dialog TV and ThePapare.com, live from a scorching Royal College Sports Complex here today. The second semi-final is between St. Thomas's College and Royal College, the traditional rivals after seeing a fantastic game yesterday. We're expecting another superb one on the cast today between these two teams. St. Thomas's finishing second in the league, Royal finishing third in the league, so absolutely nothing between these two teams to speak of. And today, knockout rugby is going to be a completely different challenge. To tell us a little bit more about what we can expect from his team, the league runners-up, Pandula De Silva, captain of St. Thomas's, joins me. Pandula, it was a little bit of a disappointing end to your season in the league championship. You're hoping to go one better today?
Yeah, unfortunately, it's not a game on top from the league final, but yeah, we have prepared really well and looking forward to play the knockouts next week as well.
You beat this team in the last minute in the league tournament, Pandula. Are you taking back happy memories from that game? Do you think that will have an impact today?
Yeah, honestly, it was a good feeling, but knockout is a different tournament altogether. So, yeah, we have prepared well, so looking forward to this game, taking this as a new game.
And you have any changes in your side today? You had a few injuries from your quarterfinal, but all okay?
Yeah, all okay. It's just Sachin Dalingi is still resting both finals.
He is on his home ground and hoping to go a little bit better than he did in the league game against St. Thomas's. Nikola, thanks a lot for joining us.
Better today? Yes, of course. We lost in the last minute in the first game, so the boys played really hard and they are for the contest.
Yes, I will spend more of my game. We have a lot of hard work and
yesterday in the semi-final, Nikhil, are you expecting another big win today?
Yeah, of course.
Thanks a lot for joining us. All the best.
Thank you.
Nikhil Bilibida, the captain of the Royal College Sports Team, and we're looking forward to a fantastic contest. The two skippers have experienced guys, so they'll be leading two big forward pairs coming out against each other. And if yesterday's first semi-finals is anything to go by, stay tuned on ThePapare.com and Dialog TV. We'll be giving you 80 minutes of cracking rugby.
Thanks for that, Tanaka, and welcome back to the commentary box. I can tell you today that we've got a very fine hard and fast track. The island's going to be excellent for up and running rugby. We've got glorious conditions. Over here there's cloud cover, but it's high and it's handsome, and it looks like it'll just be keeping in the keeping out the direct sun, that there won't be any rain clouds gathering or anything like that over today's ground. There's a slight breeze coming from left to right or from west to east as I speak. It's not much of a wind, but there's a slight one, so there'll be a little bit of an advantage if you're playing from left to right from the commentary box, as I said, if you're kicking that direction. Today we'll be finding out who's going to be joining Izzy Pantana College next week, next Saturday here at the Royal Complex Ground, to find out who's going to be in the final, and that'll be an interesting game. But in today's game, we're going to see St. Thomas's trying to do a little bit more work than they did last time they played Royal College, where they left it up to the last minute and scored had a runaway try scored, so they were just able to win that game. And we're trying to do a little bit more work so that they don't leave it up to the last second and leave their supporters hanging. As we look at the supporters now, the ground's starting to fill up, the crowd's starting to roll in through the gates. In yesterday's game, the crowd became a real factor, and as it got closer and closer to the final whistle, we saw that the crowd really started to play, especially on the referee, where he was giving a lot of advice from the sidelines. Every time he'd go near the try line of either side, the sideline was standing up. But for the last 10 minutes of the game, everyone on the sideline was standing up and trying, no one was sitting in that game yesterday. It was right down to the last minute, and it came down to, it was a matter of meters, really. Shanika, welcome.
Beating the unbeaten side, but just a game of inches in the end. The few bad decisions that they made when the goal and the team attack their mercy, and that is the proper showing that they can still go badly on their champions' head. That's why I did. And that's the one the ones that they have. They don't know what it was at the moment. A couple of bad performances, maybe from the time he didn't play as well as the side didn't play as well as he could have. And there was a 14 in terms of keeping them down a little bit yesterday, but they're still coming out the window. A ground out of win, which is important. Some players are from the league, which is just like the hangout, got the ground. And there's no answer because it's a good thing. And he's still coming out and maybe not a real standard, but a lot of people can't. And then, in my mind, I thought that was winners as well.
It's not something that we saw during the league first. but they did show an initiative to try and run the three quarters at every given opportunity. It'll be interesting to see whether they will try and do the same thing against a very good Chromium three quarter line, or whether they will revert back to just playing, you know, their 8 to 10 men roughly. But I think they realize that they can't afford to do that. Teams are catching up onto the way they play, and if they try and shift the point of attack rather than just, you know, playing half off the ground and trying to play with a bit more width, I think that could cause a bit of problems to the Estonian team.
Looking at the quarterfinal against Zanera, Abdullah, I know you have a link to Zanera in that your dad was principal there many years ago. So I'm sure you would have watched the game and seen that Zanera really took the fight to St. Thomas's early on. They held them very close in the first 40 minutes, and the game opened up in the second quarter of the last quarter of the game, actually. But that can't be the case here today, because you've got two big sides, good conditioning on both teams going up against each other. Is it early to get? Is it important to get the early blows in, or is it better to finish the game faster?
I think it's a marathon, it's not a 100-meter sprint. If you have to just go back to the last game, the Gunaratna Trophy that we played, Royal were leading until about the 76th minute, and then, you know, just a small error, a missed line-out, a knock-on, and St. Thomas just managed to pick that game. So it's a game that you have to consistently play over 80 minutes, but I think both teams, they have played at this level for a long time, so they know what they know how to pace themselves out. Just going back to Zahir, I mean, it's great that they're back again at the top level, but it just clearly showed that they just lack that exposure to consistently perform for 80 minutes. I don't think these two teams will have that problem.
Yeah, there was something we saw yesterday as well. We saw some players flying out into a lead, 13 points to nil that they were leading yesterday, and then suddenly just a couple of mistakes, a couple of missed tackles, a line break here, a line break there, a good offload here, a good offload there, and suddenly it's a 13-12 game. So you just can't afford to relax even in football rugby, can you?
That's right. But the last place down a really lot of most of the points came from the opposition, making an error and then they bring a break and throwing out a ball and someone else might have broken. What I did like about his opponent yesterday was that as soon as they made one line break, that flood the area, and that's an attitude that they have. They always support the man who makes the break, and there's always a man on the inside to take the ball.
Yes, we're expecting these teams to do battle here today. This is the home team. Nikola Gunadiro playing at prop today. Asmi Fajidin and Alex Maguranga joining him, the try scorers for the season. Harit Lakudamage, Ashwin Fernando, the two big second row units. Malisa Madhulalan, the main man in the lineup. Fadi Ladaban and Hamza Riza is starting off at number 8 today. Three positional changes in the Royal Pack. Ashok Vijayakumar pairs off with Ovin Aski today in the fly half role, moving up from fullback. Nikki George is at number 11. Puleb Hassan at 12. Janet Dilshan is probably the most dangerous three quarter in at 13. Sabit Ferro is also a fast man. And Mahima Damage shifts from probably third position this season so far, from center to wing to fullback as well. So he's got some experience, so we're probably looking to him to help start the counter-attack. He scored a couple of tries this season already. And here's the Chromium team chart coming up. Johan Pereira starting off in the front row with his captain and vice-captain, Malinda Desapriya and Thandala De Silva, the skipper. Wayne Mack, Abhi Kapilipitle and Harit Serenaita shifts to the open side, the blind side flank rather. Joshua Delisle comes in at open side. Shani Bahangama takes Takika Zabilaka's place at number 8. Sonal De Silva restored to the starting lineup. Bumin De Bitanaika is in at 10 after his injury spell of the quarterfinal. Side Nana Karas shifts to the left wing. Ashanta Herat and Danika Vijayarakna, a new center pairing for both Lada. Namin Henakan Tanambe and Meon Jayawardena, despite his ankle injury in the quarterfinal, takes his place in the last line of defense. And he will be two teams replacements. Rajapaksa, Jayawardena, Karunarakna, Nikhil De Silva, Narak Salmanana, dropped from the starting group. Vigara Mihikanta, Mohamed Shafi, and Yafis Rasmika for Royal, and Shemit Pereira, Adi Sahadun Patrana, look for him to make an impact off the bench. Fernando Atukorala, Kavin Jayasekara, Dion Dias has come off to play today. Jason Soza, Chanuka Manoratna, Hans Valpola played a key part in the quarterfinal, and Mohamed Ishak joining the replacements for the Athonians. So we'll hand over to our friend Harita Pereira, who is over at the pavilion, just overseeing the formalities for the start of the kickoff before this game. A massive crowd we have picked up today, and that's, you can see the crowd that has poured in and Tom was a little bit disappointed after their performance in the Isipathana game, and they were expecting to be crowned champions after a wonderful season, but didn't end up being so, because Isipathana came into that game with absolutely everything that they had. They had to leave it all yesterday as well. But unfortunately, for St. Thomas, that means that they have to focus only on this one. And we will ask Harita Pereira to describe the action from that pavilion side where the crowd is gathered for you in just a moment. And we'll be back in the commentary box just as the formalities conclude.
Thank you. Against the unbeaten Nishipatana team awaits the winner of this game. We'll find out who that is in just over 80 minutes' time. Joining me in the commentary box, Paul Taylor and the former Royal Captain Abdullah Yusuf as we look on the highest prize draw of the season. Navin Henakan Kanamge, the last time he played a match here, he against this opposition, he scored the last gasp winning try for his team. But winning try came a lot earlier for the blood pressure of the Chromium supporters today. But it's a hot, sporting day today at the Royal College Sports Complex, and the Milo semi-final is the waived play by referee Rohan Fernando, and they're underway through Aslam Taherat. For the ball in the first minute, and the referee just blowing it up because it was a dangerous collision. I don't think there was too much in that. I think it was a fair contest for the ball. Zananayaka just went up very high. There was a replay of that. We'll see whether there was any foul play, but I don't think so.
Once the replay comes out, we'll see that. I think the players both had their eyes on the ball, and that's what's important here. The both focused on the ball, and that's probably what's got this got the players in trouble here. They don't see each other.
Yes, it was a bit of a nasty collision for sure. Referee having a small chat with his assistant referee, just checking to see whether everything is in order. And that looks like it's
Adit Navaratna, the second rower, took a nasty tumble, but no intent in it. Referee blew it up very quickly just to check on the safety of the players. Should probably restart with a scrum, but he's gone with a penalty nevertheless. Probably ruled that the royal player didn't get up off the ground perhaps, and that's why it wasn't a fair contest. But maybe a little bit unlucky, and early chance of points. So turning life lemons into lemonade here, St. Thomas probably.
That's right, this is an opportunity here to put some points on the board, and that was very unlucky for full Royal College. I thought the players were waiting for the ball to come, and as he's waiting, looking at the ball, a Tombian flies into him and he's already up in the air, and you get penalised.
What Tombi now, I was just pointing out yesterday, St. Thomas's need to make use of the aerial bombardment in the first half. That's where the sun will affect this Royal College fullback and a new fullback as well, because they have Mahima Damage, who actually moving into the last line of defense. He hasn't played a lot of rugby there, so it should be an interesting test for him if they choose to bomb him. Aswan Taherat has been a steady accumulator of points for the Estonian team. Scored quite a few tries in this season as well and has been pretty good with the boots. Strokes that nice and lazily through, and it's just wide of the right hand upright. But a good early nerve settler for Aswantha. Good legs on that one with a nice easy strike.
It was an easy strike. It looked like Thomas the boot well. It just faded away to the right here, and still St. Thomas's have Royal College into in their own half, so they'll be looking to run the ball back with some venom.
This is Asok Vijay Kumar, Royal's linchpin. The whole team has been built around this fulcrum, and he puts it long, unsurprisingly, into the arms of Miran Jayawardena. Jayawardena suffered an ankle injury against Zahira, but he seems to have recovered well from that. Beats three tacklers, and Mr. Brown is taking 20 meters. Ball available for Senal De Silva, moving the Disa Nayaka to his captain, Pandula. Stays on his feet nicely. And now it's quick ball, but St. Thomas's don't really have a back line. They've gone. And here's Malinda Deshapriya, the vice captain. Here's Ashwanta Herat, now looking for Mayan Jayawardena. Jayawardena with a little kick through. And Mahima Gamage, it's an awkward bounce for him. Navin Hena Kantanamge will shepherd him to the touch line, and Gamage makes the sensible, takes a sensible option, puts it into touch.
So that's how I like to put the ball into a right. You saw that the right-footed fullback may have no option but to put the ball into touch, but because his right-footed, his angle was all wrong, and he could only make maybe, I don't know, 3 or 4 metres with that kick. So I like to use that again. It's a good option for the St. Thomas.
Abdullah, a lot will rest, today's result will rest on this line-out, and how it goes, this particular set-piece is going to be really important for both teams.
Particularly for Royal Sharnagar, because a well-known fact that it's the key platform from which Royal launch most of their attacks.
Sonanayaka wins it beautifully in the middle. He's a massive incursion to the side today. And the referee's got his arm up for a collapse. Doing the Sonanayaka knows the penalty is coming. Tanisha Vijayaratna in the centers today. Makes some ground. And it's quickly available for doing the Sonanayaka, but it's man on man. Sarit Nanyakara stands strong, the centre, now turned winger. St. Thomas is getting their forwards there quickly enough. And Tehan Pereira now goes and is helped with the clean out by Wayne Mack. Pandula De Silva, they're still playing advantage. Domingo Adisa Nayaka puts the hammer down and goes over to the left. The good three left from St. Thomas, they've got numbers on the left. Christian Delisle looks to take it. Royal line was up quickly, he didn't have any options there. Pandula De Silva, lovely hands. Pandula De Silva, after for Mack. Wayne Mack is over the line. Referee was pretty late getting there, but the test was on hand. And they didn't need the advantage from the line out. St. Thomas, good hands from Pandula De Silva, set that line out up. And it looks like the early ball has been struck. But Royal will know that this is a game, as Abdullah was saying earlier, it's not a 100 meter dash, it's a marathon.
Oceanica, some really good pace play there by St. Thomas's. The hill position, the build up the phases,
Royal were a bit passive in defense at first. They were not attacking, they were not sprinting up in defense. They let the Thomians coming at them, and with the Thomians constantly getting over the gain line, Royal were always on the back foot. But I think that was a very positive start by St. Thomas's.
That's right. I thought they, with their body language at defense time, that they weren't walking through honor tails and rushing forward as an attacking defensive line. They were really standing back on their heels and letting St. Thomas's come through, and as we wait for the conversion to come in.
I want to hear that, taking the conversion just in front of the Royal bench. And it looks like it's good this time. Yes, it is. The assistant goal is good by Floyd Jobs. The big kick from Hallett from the touchline almost. And Wayne Max Fry is iced with that two-pointer. So now it depends on how Royal respond here and how St. Thomas is really with the restart. As a coach, Paul, you must be tearing your hair out about how teams deal with restarts here.
Yeah, that's right. They won't. As a coach, that's one of the main things you want to try and organise that. As soon as the ball comes back, once you've scored, the ball comes back, you reset, and you really want to get the ball out of your own half and restart down in the opposition's half and put the pressure back on them. So we'll see what happens here.
Ashok with the restart. It's flat and taken on the bounce. Good hit in defense by Ashok and Fernando. Sinal de Silva. And they've gone around the back this time, but good attacking defense there from Johnny Gudilchan. He's been really flying up in defense for Royal this whole season. And St. Thomas is not clearing their lines, as Paul was talking about just a moment or two ago. And here's Joshua Delia. Royal now through Nikila Gunadira. Standing right. And Royal has a chance of attacking now for the first time in this game. Predictable cut from the Royal first receiver, but they've got the penalty coming. And Ashok knows that, so he's put the little chip kick in, which was done excellently by Salik Nana Kara, but the penalty is coming. And Owen Askew will probably have a pop.
Which was a very good in the West game, and I think that was probably the difference between the two teams. The amount of turnovers they managed to get at the breakdown. West were very slow to get numbers committed to the breakdown, and Royal were very good at turning ball over, and it was the same case here. So it's something which St. Thomas will need to be mindful of. They need to get numbers at the breakdown, because Royal have got some very good photos, and it's a good opportunity for Royal to get some points on the board and hit back immediately.
I've noticed Royal don't put in a lot of numbers at breakdowns until they decide this is the one we're going to go for. And then when they go for it, they flood it and give themselves a really good opportunity to turn the ball over.
If you can't stress enough how technically proficient this Royal forward pack is, whatever their trade is, they do it really well. Especially at the breakdown, their body positions are good at attack and defense. And they've got great strength over the ball, which is why they get as many turnovers as Abdullah was saying. So St. Thomas's will have to make sure they don't isolate themselves. It has been the... And yes, it's good. So Royal through Owen Askew get themselves on the board at the first opportunity. And it's 7-3, and the pressure is back on the Thomians to make sure they don't allow this lead to slip away.
Shanika, the kickoff is such an important part. Both teams from the kickoff were unable to get back into the opposition's half, and both teams have ended up conceding points. As you mentioned very correctly, the kickoff is a very, very important part of the game.
Josh Antohera will hope to put some pressure on the receiver here. But again, St. Thomas's woes continuing in being isolated in the lineout. It goes up once again. The referee waves play on, but it looks like St. Thomas's have managed to wrestle this ball back. It's available for Sinal de Silva. It's a little sniping, but Royal Kings defense are having none of it. Tehan Pereira, good low body position. Pandula de Silva changes direction. Skipper. And here's Gominda Disanayake to Aswan Tahira. He's met by three head of defenders. Really good body positions again from Royal, slowing that ball down legally. Damage of Vijayaratne. Manages to find the offload to Mehan Jaiwa. It was a risky pass, but he was created that time. And Damage again. Jahan Pereira clearing out. And here's Serenayaka.
No, no.
St. Thomas was not taking the same mistake in this part of the ground that they did in their own half. That's a nice little kick through, but seemed like it ricocheted. And St. Thomas has given the ball away, unfortunately for them, after a good build-up.
No, no.
And Royal will look to clear their lines through Aski. Moving the Disanaik, allowing the ball to bounce twice. Needed to get to where his forwards were, and he did that well enough. Aswan Tahira, that first receiver. Yes, Mehan Jaiwa, then Danuja Vijayaratne. Vijayaratne ignoring Henakan Kanamge, who had a yawning gap outside him. Here's Aswan Tahira picking it up and going again, and it's good quick ball. So, Philippic, yeah, it looked like it was a knock on that the referee missed. And now, calling for the ball, St. Thomas's. Through Jahan Pereira, quick ball from Danuja Vijayaratne, manages to get the offload away. Farid Nanayakar steps back inside. He was accompanied by the medical staff on the field attending to a Royal player. Delisle has been looking to run with the ball today, breaks the defensive tackle. And now Royal has turned it over again. So it's the second ball Delisle has turned over in a couple of minutes.
Step back!
And really needs to look after the ball. Despite making those yards, he's not doing his team any favors.
Use it!
And Royal will look to get a better clearance. And the big falls down and it's bounced over there. Looked like that player might have been offside.
Advantage! Number 12 offside!
But Rosso is saying, it's interesting to see the replay there because the kick was charged down, but I guess everybody becomes unexpected.
Yeah, that's right. Everyone does become onside, but then another ref forms. And now, they almost come down on the right side, but the ball wasn't played out, and then the player played the halfback, so that's why he got penalized.
It's like I think the both teams are a bit guilty in trying to play a bit too much rugby in their own half. I think the Royal on the previous occasion needed to have found touch because St. Thomas will have got a really good counter-attacking game. They need to slow the pace down because St. Thomas has seen intent on playing the game at a fair pace. And the Thetonians as well, when they conceded at 3 points, they're just trying to play far too much rugby in their own half. So it's something which both teams, I think, will need to rectify soon.
Well, this is an ideal opportunity for a nice big bomb. Nice up and under. Mahima Gamage is staring into the sun. But Buminda Disanayake, this Thetonian team is not going to die wandering. They're going to run as much as they can. And Royal will have the first opportunity. Well, they're not choosing to mull it today. And they're looking to come off the back. Hamza will bristling run tail of the line out. Interesting to see that one again. See the Royal forwards actually leave the line out early. But Bilsan doing really well to recover the ball. Delisle helped by his winger, holding that ball up just for a moment or two. Nikila Gunadiro now the skipper. Help from him as well. Aswan Tahira getting back forward. Here's the run from Ayush Maduranga. He's the tight head. This season. Danuja Vijayaratne goes in after the ball. And this time it's Ashok Vijayaku Awinaski. St. Thomas is getting in over there. Good counter ruck. The ball is available, so well controlled there by Royal. Did really well. And Ashok Vijayaku whole acres of space. And finds it nicely. Sarit Nanayakara on the left wing for the first time this season, leaving a bit of space behind him. And just as Isipathana found St. Thomas is out on positional play, Paul, again, Maran Jawa not as well positioned as he could have been for that kick.
That's right. I've had Manas Sala get across there. There was no one actually back on the other side on the far side for our role, and there were two chances as well. So, Manas Jawa, it's the four of them that made a tough play of the back.
Given that Isana Aika again looking to run, I'm not sure this is the right option. Nani Jawa, nobody wants the ball. And now, it looks like Royal had a poor sandwich for us. Good tackle there by Henakant Anange. And that's the little top coming. And it's bouncing into the hands of the player.
Was not forward.
But referee says not forward. I'm sure he should have allowed advantage there because Namin had the ball in his hand. He just wanted to take it to touch. But giving them a 5 meter scrum, I don't know whether that's really advantage play.
I think on the both sides, there was a knock on from both sides. That's why he was forced to blow that up. But what one bit of vision by Ashok there, he saw the space at the back. Just unfortunately not a good bounce for the Royal Wing who was chasing down.
Yes, again, the Thomian back three found a little wanting in the ability to control that short ball. Madam Moran on this side, eyeing up his target.
Wanted.
Govinda Dishanayaka has no option but to run it out of trouble. And Ashwan Taherat does well to back up his fly half. And now they'll look for the pocket for Govinda to clear, which he does. But now they'll have problems.
Not mine.
And looking at Madhumaran, as we were before the scrum, the referee says that number 7 was not bound. Probably got a call from his assistant referee, so an unfortunate penalty for Royal to give away when they had St. Thomas's under the cosh.
They were putting a lot of pressure on the scrum side, and the result of it was that sort of dribbly pass there that came back away, bounced from almost rolled to number 10, and that put a lot of pressure on it. It was illegal there.
It's just the kind of position you don't want to concede a penalty, isn't it, Shanika? Because you're just 5 meters out from your opposition line. Even if they kick it back to touch, chances are, with the angle they had, you could have just taken the maximum up to the 22 and they would have had the ball back. But unfortunately, Royal conceding a penalty and position back in some points.
And it's not just an isolated incident, Abdullah. We've seen so many schools just do this when they're on the attacking 5 meters from, just give away a silly penalty and squander any chances. Serenayaka with a lovely ball off the top. And Bhuminder Dishanayaka puts in a big kick, fielded well by Sabit Feroz. Feroz has some room to run now. Runs across the field, doesn't matter if he makes tackles. Now running back in and met in a smash. A big Thomas defender. But he's got his team back into the attacking momentum. Vijay Kumar. Here's Nicky Lagunabira taking a ball off Ovinaski. Going short side once again, Gunabira the captain. Tackle on him by Anuja Vijayaratna in the centers today. St. Thomas is really winning the collisions here. And Royal playing from a lot of depth. Aski has to spin around because he didn't catch the ball cleanly. And they turned it over. Didn't look like that was a clean clearance there. It was not getting out of the way clearly by the Thomian defender there. Danija Vijayaratna, I think it was, fell over the ball and didn't roll away. Or maybe Wayne Mack is having a chat to referee Fernando.
Yeah, that's right. They didn't quite get away quick enough, and it just slows down the ball for a while, and that means that they're unable to roll any momentum. But you see the team for all, the team that looked to pass that wide, and he's still running one attacker out to his left, and that's why they did that little spin and came back because he didn't want to throw a hospital pass.
Well, that's a new one. I've heard Fly love throwing those. Usually thrown into forwards, no less. And the scrum is not stable. The referee will blow this up. Abdullah, we were talking yesterday about the new changes to the scrum and the new law variations. and the scrum will be allowed to be played even if it goes down after it has been hooked. So you will see less resets, and also the weird scrum is going to go back to the original put-in rather than going to the defending team, so we'll probably see less wheeled scrums as well. So good changes, positive changes coming in.
It's all about trying to speed up the pace of the game, isn't it, Chanukka? To be more spectator friendly, the less stoppages you have in this game of rugby, the better it's for everyone.
It is. I just hope the stoppage part of becoming rugby late there, and the penalty coming. Going in on the angle on the far side, says the referee, is eagle eyed to have spotted that from where he was. Vinodino, the captain, is the one who's stunned. And now Vijayaratna has to make sure he finds touch, going for the far touchline, and it looks well thought. Vijay Kumar will take his time. There's a little bit of a dance and tackled.
Okay, play on.
Not sure that was the right option from him. But again, St. Thomas is guilty of just not finding touch when they needed to. Not understanding why bringing the Dishanayaka doesn't take these kicks, and now they've got numbers well. They use chance to move it. Askey. Quick ball to Sabit Perez. Honekan Kanange makes up the ground on him and drives him into touch. Defending very narrow there.
You hear yourself in the replay, the ball comes out, and they've got huge numbers out here. There's only two defenders, and there's a big skip pass that really skipped out attackers rather than defenders. And
number 15
there! Just comes along and ragdolls him across. But he just drifted off across, and he was making time on me, waited for the last man to have the pass, and then came on and drifted onto the last attacker.
You're much better.
At that point, they should have actually just played hands and drawn and passed, drawn and passed. We saw a lot of that good stuff yesterday.
Again, a good win from Sananayaka at the middle of the lineout. Vijayaratna, they're using him as a battering ram today, Jeremy Roberts style in midfield. Biminda Dishanayaka, Mayan Jayawardena beats the first tackle, but not completely. And Royal turns over again. Outstanding work by Royal in the loose. St. Thomas has really had to protect the ball here. They're giving it away way too many times in their half, and as Abdullah was pointing out, the technical proficiency of this Royal pack in the tackle situation may be the aspect that wins the game for them today.
Mark,
I'd like to see them take advantage of that turnover ball a little bit better, and that they need to realign quicker. They seem to be a little bit ponderous on that, and so what they actually do is they just end up picking the ball up and then having one pass. But the space is at one pass. The space is in two or three passes away. So they can realign and take up their own space in the field, get good depth, then they'll be able to find space with that turnover ball.
This part, I think it's also, I know sometimes it's a big deal to account for how much rugby as well. The seam on Canton taking at least one hit and just giving it out. But they seem to be lacking numbers in support out wide, and Royal are pouncing. It's not just the forwards. That occasion, I think it was the right wing of Royal who actually turned that ball over. So they need to be mindful of that and correct numbers to the breakdown to ensure that they're not in the same position.
That scrum looks a little untidy, but the referee will allow it to be played on as Vijay Kumar breaks on the blind side. And his forwards help him out to turn it into a good ball once again. Gunadira. Right into the wall, blue and black. It's available for Vijay Kumar, who puts in a little outside of the foot kick. And Aslan Kahirat will have a little bit of time, but he knew the penalty was coming. Vijay Kumar, and you can be sure that Askey will line this one up. So, after this tournament is over, we're done with the rugby, and for the first time in history, ThePapare.com will sponsor the Under-19 Schools Basketball Tournament, the ThePapare Basketball Championship, from 8th to 17th July. You can follow the live webcast from the quarterfinals onwards. So, just as I was saying, that we'll be sure that Ashley lines this up, they choose instead to use the momentum that they've built up in the last few minutes and go for the touchline and use that weapon that they have in their armory at all. No prizes for guessing what's coming next.
Well, I think the reality is rolling on. We thought that earlier on when they had a complicated move, but they still got all the advantage going, and that's an important thing.
Now one, four.
Very interesting to see how the referee blows this here. It looked like it was stopped once already.
Number three.
And now it's coming backwards.
One.
Good body positions by the Thomians this time, but the wall breaking off the back and yes, well, I've got the try. Can buy a seat and the best up, but I say Pujo Kuma is the man who shifts the Thomian defenders.
Number three.
And he's got the try. Can see it from another angle, I'm sure. Barasek has been deadly at the back of this driving Moyes as well. He's sizing up exactly where the space is and snipes right through them, even if the pilots can't get over. He's already stopped there.
Here's the another time take the ball in, and they set a great driving ball here. It's compact, it's low, they're all driving together. It's communication around it. You'll see the halfback, he just watches and looks to see where the. Once it's sometimes just commit everyone in, then there's the hole.
Yes, that was a shocking defense by Bumindo Disanayake and Chanal De Silva there. You've got to be on the last foot, expecting the fringe guy to break off, and that was just lazy defending.
It's not the but I guess, is the reputation that preceded this Royal College Mall. They'd probably expect Royal to just try and drive over, not expecting Ashok to break. Once again, I mean, he's such an intelligent player. He's able to identify space, either with his boot or with the ball in hand. And that was just a fantastic bit of vision by Ashok on that occasion.
Outstanding kick by Owen Askew. You can see why the one down advantage is actually an advantage, because Askew can kick them from anywhere here. So Royal now bustling into the lead, 10-7. And St. Thomas is playing as much rugby as they can, but playing it on the wrong end of the pitch.
Look, we've seen St. Thomas is in a situation before where they've been behind the red ball and they've had times dominate them. They do have patience and they do have buy-up in their own skill and their own terms of battle to come back. But they really just need to go back to the basics, I believe, and instead of trying to move the ball too wide, hold on to it, have to go a little bit narrower in their attack.
That's an interesting restart from Aslan Taherak. Puts it into the space so he can get a set piece in Royal's territory. First going to kick the ball out, perhaps.
You mark here, Blue.
It's an interesting to see the option Royal takes. We've been commenting from the kickoff. Both teams have been bogged down, getting bogged down in their own half. I think Royal should just look at trying, I think it's just to try and drive the stormy and pack. Right, and you don't get a good chase in, because you don't want to be playing too much rugby in your own half, and I think that's been the downfall of St. Thomas so far.
Well, that's an interesting one. Royal have sent the winger into the line-out.
That's it.
Now, Nicky George has come all the way from the left wing into the line-out, and it looks like Royal are going to drive this one forward. St. Thomas is getting better behind it this time, eventually, and that was a stop. Didn't see the referee calling it though. And now it's kept again, so he's got to use it.
Give that number three.
The referees have absolutely no clue about how to do this. It's stopped for about the third time now.
Seven.
And it's stopped again. And now there's a little bit of a gap for John Bolton, who gets smashed by Donegal Ligaratna.
On your feet!
I can't hear it going over the top there. But well protected by Royal. Here's Fajidin. On the blind side, so Royal getting their numbers across the field. And now they've got some numbers that they can use. It's just the same number. And now Royal can move it to Askew. Disanayake had gotten across to cover Mitchell George.
Now look!
That's a loopy pass. But the Royal receiver doing well. And again, Mitchell Kumar with some nice quick ball. Right over the top to Sabit Feroz. Feroz has two men to clear out, and eventually Vijayaratna grabs him. Well, to make a bigger impact there at the breakdown, but. Now they've got numbers shifting out to the left side.
No, no,
Well, again, the defenders. Malinda disappears. Hits the tackle nicely. And now it's a slow ball from Royal, but Fajuddin does well.
No.
Here's Nikhil Gunadira, the skipper, held up nicely by Dhanuja Vijayaratna, but manages to go down just as his forwards get there. And again, a short ball. This is your style of play, Ashwin Fernando. St. Thomas is choosing not to commit numbers to those rocks. And now Fernando Soya, who has it? And he's looking for a willing runner. Ashwin Fernando is the man. Just couldn't get the ball away. And Mayan Jaiwa is going to take the inside pass. And the Royal have turned it over once again. That was great work from them. And finally, the penalty comes for St. Thomas. Royal are doing some great work on the field.
I think Kanata, they have retained possession over the last 3 or 4 minutes, but from the original lineup, they have not made any progress. That's what we were talking about earlier. And now they're given the opportunity for St. Thomas. They've got an option of either reporting to touch and launching an attack or going for 3 points. I think the Royal have got to find a way of where they can play a bit more rugby in the Thomian half, where they'll be more effective and able to apply a bit more pressure. Because they're just trying to hammer them up at the forwards, and the Thomian defense is standing tall, and they're not making much progress. And as you saw, there was just one knock-on after so many phases, and now Thomians are back on the attack.
Yes, they decided, I think, very deliberately not to commit numbers to the breakdown. So hitting them, bringing them down, and just standing off. And this is a crucial line-out for St. Thomas's. Beautiful one by Serenaika once again, and they will try to give Royal a dose of their own medicine, but it's pulled down immediately. Thomas is still fighting their way into the corner. They will look to their big men. And again, no advantage coming. Thought the referee could have played a little longer.
Look like you're penalising someone to come in on the angle or in from the side of that rolling mall. And St. Thomas is just decided what to do. We're talking about the Royal attack earlier, and already using the forwards. If I can work with the spaces, I feel like they're attacking down on the closest side to us. If they're going to the inside, there are only two defenders there. They only needed to send 3 men, that means, and then they're through. So they just need to identify where the space is, and that's the area to attack.
And that's very nice for America's hands. Again, they've got to look for the options, and nice job of Phillips. It's good for them. So the advantage is with Bowen, the defender, who chooses to not pass the ball again.
Use it.
Wayne Mack, sorry, Malin the base up here. This is again isolated. And here's Tari Bahangama. You haven't seen him carrying the ball. It's not a good pass to him, though.
No.
There's way to return the ball. And now, Pandula De Silva. Good hands from him to Sananayaka. Cuts back on the angle. Senal De Silva, booming the Disanayaka with a long ball out to Saritnane Akkaru. He's bootless, he's well done by the winger. And now the penalty is coming, so well, this time he approached it illegally. Number one, so it's a referee. Having a chat and saying that he expects them to roll away and release the tackler. So, skipper Gunadira trying to get into the referee's ear, and all the good captains do that.
Well, if he does roll away and release the tackle player, he'll be running on his ball at this game.
And final phase. Confidence dented after the line out left has got to take the pass. And again, Royal using the foot, and the referee may go to his pocket immediately.
Number 3 coming.
So once again, you know, we were having a chat and it looks like, oh, Smother Anger may be going to the bin. Yes, he is. And that's a huge blow for all, a huge, huge blow, because he's one of the try scorers. And he's a big cog in that big Royal defensive unit. So two penalties on the track for Madhuranga, which is why he saw the yellow card. And let's see what St. Thomas has chose to do from here. They're not sure taking the storm, especially after the forward has gone to the bin. That's a bit of a interesting decision.
So we're going to take the point and we're going to come back and start again. And that's what it's all about. We've got an opportunity now, 10 minutes against Portland. Whether they're kicks, four tries, or whatever it is, they're not going to accumulate points right now. And the forward will manage the game now. Now they need to be up tempo, try to make sure that the ball stays in play as long as they can and keep rolling down the Royal College team.
Yeah, that leans back as he strikes it, and it has gone well. So it's a 10-point all game. And he's going to win the game from Thomas is up to the top of the game. He will have the game well as well. And now very intelligently looked to slow this game down. You can see Vijay Kumar already walking back very slowly to the mark. Nothing wrong with that.
Yes, I think we need to be a bit smarter. It's about 5 minutes to the break. You just need to try and pin St. Thomas's in their own half. Just play four for half time and just hope that they can wear this 14-man play down and not concede any points. And they lost their attack once they are up to the 5 points in the 15 players.
Yeah, it's Sabit for us again. It's not a good kick chase. And Mahina Ganage. And has allowed that turnover from Bilal. It's well done by him. And that's the space. Well spotted by Bhumin Gadisanayaka. And the chance is on from Banuja Vijayaratna. But Vijay Kumar gets back. He has really been the rock around which Royal have been built. And that ball has gone out. And it should be Tomian ball. It is.
It was very much in this last pass there. The fullback came in and took the corner attack. Marion and covered him. So everyone was up in the line for a while and there was lots of space back there. And so it was a great kick.
It could have been made better, make a better chase, but just not enough pressure on Vijay Kumar. And that's an area of the game that Coach Laga will have to work on. And that is a fake. And that's a mistake that cannot be made at this level, especially not in this position. Pandila De Silva dummying the throw there. You can see it very clearly. And Roy had read that line out beautifully. Well taken there by the winner on the far side. And now Roy will look to spin it wide. They've got some numbers. Herat. Banuja Vijayaratna missing an important tackle there. And St. Thomas has had another turnover. Malinda disappear. And they will come back for the penalty. So St. Thomas should probably take this quickly and bang it down the field. Because there's nobody at home.
Well, the ball's well, they've got less than 2 minutes on the clock, so they won't want to kick it out and then take the line out, so they really need to manage this time well. They're against 14 men, and they're just walking around as if they're waiting for the dinner bell.
I'm not sure that was the correct option by Ashok on that occasion to try and spread the ball. Their men, they're pulled down, they need to just suck up time, and it would have been better if they had kept it on the fringes and just tried and played for the toss, because it's just a couple of minutes more for half time, and if they can just keep this 10-point lead, I'm sure, if we can keep a 10-point fall, I think they'll feel much better going into the break.
Yes, Royals, first priority must be not to concede in this period where they've got one of their key players up. Found Lady Seal, we want to do better at the lineout this time, and it is better when Mac manages to secure it.
No,
and it's a knock forward.
says the referee. So we're having a scrum after a fairly long layoff. And here's where the change will need to be made. A third row forward will need to go up for a front rower to come on. So Maturanga is off the tight head. Gunadira is in the second row, and it looks like they're putting Harit Lokoganage into the second row position. He's played in the front row before.
It's just simply I need to just keep an eye on this short side here. They have Hino contact again on this right flank, and I'm sure they will plan, be planning something along this line. So, well, we have to keep an eye on that.
Yes, it's probably an 8-9-14 move that they're going for. Nice little kick through for Hino contact and get a chase. It's a good bounce. And Santana says they'll be playing that the half time whistle doesn't come.
Here is the laconic style from the royal fullback. Just sort of wanders back and picks the ball up, flips the ball in. He didn't know that was coming on the way. Looks like time's up. Just enough time for one more play.
And that's a good win by San America, but it's a bad bounce for San Jose Silva. Going wide and cutting back nicely on the angle was done as a loser right now. And not sure what that was for. Holding on for the referee. So again, St. Thomas is isolating themselves and giving away a penalty at a crucial moment. This is where the ball was left, and that's where the trouble that the creator, he watched the penalty here. Don't know whether that was really something that could be penalized. The ref was very quick to blow that up. And don't forget the audio analysis of the Sri Lanka Tour of England on Cricketry. You can catch the updates each match day with Roshan Abhisinger. Just the T20 match coming up. And it's 10 points there, nothing in it between St. Thomas's and Royal. And just as we saw last evening, just a one-point game going into halftime here, there's no points in it. 10 points there, a try and a penalty apiece for both teams. And Royal, with about 5 minutes left to play with one man down, let's see how they weather that storm. St. Thomas's and Royal back with the Milo President's Trophy second semi-final, live from the Royal College Sports Complex here on ThePapare.com and Dialog TV. We'll be back in just a bit.
Kapapa. Oh, Venus Villa.
Jackson Anthony Cinema Nirvana. Address Nasa
Paramanyat.
Then Dialog Television 7th Circuit Channel Ose.
Bullet Dekak Adi. Dekak Oyo Lord. Anika Mago Lord.
Dialog Television introduces Dialog TV Go, now on your smart device. Anytime, anywhere, any network. Choose from over 40 channels with features like Rewind and Catch Up TV for absolutely free. Download the Dialog View app on your Android device and click on Dialog TV Go. Or search for Dialog TV Go on your iOS device and click Get to Download. Your favorite show wherever you go. Dialog Television, Sri Lanka's number one television experience.
Super Rugby on Satanta Sports. All nine ties from round 16 live, including the Blues meet the Brumbies.
They must go in, they do! The Blues!
The Waratahs entertain the Hurricanes in Sydney.
Ralph Allow is on the gallop, and he goes!
Oh, that's a try!
And the Jaguars welcome the Highlanders to Buenos Aires.
Love it, they will take it all the way.
Super Rugby, round 16. Watch every game on Satanta.
To activate this channel, use the Dialogue Self-Care app or type on space your Dialogue television account number, space channel number, and SMS to 679 from your Dialogue mobile or 0770-679-679 from any other mobile network.
The tournament which everyone wants to win, and St. Thomas's and the Royal are fighting for a place in the final next Saturday against the Isipathana team, which came through a heart-wrenching game yesterday against St. Peter's. St. Peter's was outstanding in that match, just losing in the last gasp to a rolling ball try by Isipathana. They had the chance to put it away and they didn't do that. Both these teams are doing battle today. They have also had their own chances, some of them taken, some of them not, as we see an anxious crowd moving on these two teams. Royal and St. Thomas's doing battle for the second time this season. St. Thomas's winning the league encounter by a whisker, and Royal hoping that they won't repeat that performance today as well. Royal on their home grounds. Owinaski kicked a crucial conversion and a penalty from the touchline to take Royal into a 10-7 lead after St. Thomas's had scored first. And now St. Thomas's with Ashwan Behera's penalty have fought back, and Royal have iced Maduranga in the field for about 5 more minutes, and St. Thomas's may be hoping that they can exploit those 5 minutes in the fight and hope that Royal will just burn out a little bit more gas than they have to in the defensive efforts. Joining me in the commentary box, Paul Toya and former Royal captain Abdullah Yusuf watching this game. Paul, from the first exchanges of those 40 minutes, where do you think this game is going to be won and lost?
Overall, I don't think I want to lock my mind here. Today, both teams are giving everything, and I'm feeling that's one of those things that's going to be the end of the season. So, in my mind, I have to understand that the pressure that's going to come on, and the pressure's going to, as it gets past and close to the end of the season, to one of those things, the pressure in the mind is going to become more and more, and that's when decision making becomes more crucial. Right now, I think. St. Thomas has obviously have a numerical advantage, but it's such an enormous that there isn't any clear advantage being taken by the team. I think both teams are the same. If they're defending the territory, it's going to win this match, I think, today.
Yes, and both teams, as Abdullah has been talking, have not been playing the territorial game smartly enough. Neither St. Thomas nor Royal playing the game in the correct half. They are looking to let the running rugby do the talking. It's not the conditions or the situation for that at the moment. So Abdullah is saying, I think the coaches will have brought home the importance of playing the kicking game and getting into the right areas of the field.
Hopefully so, from both sides. But I think playing for a great second half, because it's been on both teams. Replayed, Royal just need to manage the next 5 minutes carefully, because just a player down, if they can get over that initial period, then I think it will be game on.
It was a difficult match in the quarterfinals for both these teams. Rusty and Zahira putting in spirit of performance first. That is the reason why Rusty is head band there. He's doing quite a bit of tackling today. He's in the centers. He started trying to try to move to the wing. Neither of the two winners have really made any telling contributions for St. Thomas's, although Stardust Perez has seen quite a bit of the ball. for Royal. Yesterday, I think both Nate Abraham made the injection, the replacement, really at a very opportune moment when he brought on Ribeiro for Randy Silva, who was having a poor game by his own standards. And that change really made a difference the way Stockton were playing this game. They were going forward a lot more. And that's where the bench also compared to his really important changes in football.
The first player to come down,
Rafi Fernando having a chat to both captains, pointing at his watch there. I'm not sure what he was talking about. I think he was talking to the scoreboard and saying, look, it's my watch that's got the time, correct time on it, not the scoreboard clock. Allowing that ball to bounce into Henakan Kanamge's hands there. First time he's touched the ball in a while. And now Dishanayake needs to keep this in play. And it looks like the message has come from Coach Laga. This is where St. Thomas's need to chase and chase hard. And Mahima Ganage puts a good boot to the ball and gets his team all the way back almost to the 50. That's where the chase could have made a difference to St. Thomas's. Brought them maybe 10 or 15 meters, but the kick chase from the Thomians has been probably a weaker part of their game.
That's right. It wasn't a good look. It was a great kick, but also the positioning of the rear fullback wasn't quite where it should have been. But that's the corner that they need to kick to, that corner where the right-footed player finds a tough coach to get a good angle and can't quite understand the process.
So Tony and Lineout has let them down a couple of times in this game as well. At crucial times, you can see how important it is. Navaratna goes up and Mac tidies up again.
Stay back.
Dishanayake to Henakan Kanamge, who's coming off his wing. We're just talking at halftime off air as to how we wanted him to come into the game a little bit more, and he has done that, dragged his team over the advantage line, and Danuja Vijayaratna may have overcooked this. He has. It's the right idea, but just the execution wanting there from Vijayaratna. He's got a big powerful boot and didn't know the strength of it himself.
He's got also a little bit more disguise would be good. As soon as he got the ball in his hands, he just shakes a kick. He was only one option for him. At least you look like you're going to take a run and sort of draw the defense to you and then put the little kick in.
There have just been a couple of minutes into this second half. Already Thomians have kicked the ball twice. It's probably as much as they kicked it in the first half. So probably the message has gone out. I think the Royal need to be a bit aware of this shift of strategy by the Thomians.
No meaningful contest there by St. Thomas's, and Royal have set there. And this is once the referee has got to call it, surely. He's got to say one. Now he does eventually. That looked like a truck and trailer for all intents and purposes. Now it's stopped again. So good defense by St. Thomas's. Delisle missing, dropping off the tackle. Tehan Pereira has to make it. And that was beautifully done by the Royal player. Referee says play on. It was a turnover by Malinda Deshapri. And here's Aswan Taherat. Long ball out to Tanuja Vijayaratna. Steps through a tackle. He's got a man that leaves the ball on the floor.
Advantage, play on this.
Here's the replay. That's the step inside. Takes him past Aski, but here's where the timely intervention from Gunadira comes in. But you're talking about trying to shape for a run and then do the kick. Tanuja Vijayaratna in those luminous green tights of his and the headband. He's not the subtlest player on the park. You see, Paul, he's a rope run kind of guy.
Well, I'm an ice player, and there was the introduction of those coloured boots, and I know I bought smashing boots when I was playing, and I just said, please come and every time I have the ball, smash me.
But if you're back and you wear pink boots, you'd better be that size.
One
point. More sensitive. I thought we just came off into the
Royal. It doesn't matter. He's going for the corner, almost in. Bilal goes in and
doesn't protect the ball well enough from the Royal counter up. They need to pick this up quickly. And again, the change of angle doesn't work for Royal. The knock forward comes. How did St. Thomas contrive not to score that? CJ Delisle needed to go in and smash the defender and make sure he kept that ball available. The next guy needed to pick it up. This is just too much rugby in their own half, or just playing too much rugby, as Abdullah was saying. Guys that size don't need to pass the ball to us from 5 meters away from the try line.
Yeah, there's the sign, keep it simple, stupid. That's what they didn't do there. I tried to move the ball around. Really, the space there is on the far side. You've got a short side and just keep going the same way, because the defense is coming, is flooding back and forth, and it always resets on the open side.
So, a little bit of instability in the scrum. Referee Fernando blowing it up, and Royal very cleverly, knowing that there's just a couple more minutes for Maduranga to come on.
Just a quick observation. We all need to be very careful in the scrum, even on the previous scrum where the goal is scrum up. I think it was a fact that they're one man short, and the ball probably shot out from that empty gap. So they need to be able to secure this ball properly.
Sometimes it's that again they give away the pass in a crucial position. Looks to take it quickly, but can see the referee pointing to the far side. You can see Tehan Pereira's side of the loose head here, lifting and going up. So you can see telltale body position is where he's moving his left shoulder upwards, and that's what gives the indication to the referee that he's going sideways.
Really did need to do that, didn't it, Shanta? Just I think the second time the tournament has given Royal a penalty just close to their try line and given Royal the opportunity to probably now just take this line out, drive it, play for the puck, and they'll be back to 15 players.
I think he may already be on as well, Abdullah. But again, St. Thomas is squandering a really good position. St. Thomas has been as profligate as Arsenal Football Club in front of goal. They've been as bad as Germany and Italy were in that penalty shootout last morning. My goodness, that was horrible. And St. Thomas has not been that much better. Another one. And they've chosen to engage it. That's step one. They haven't played it. Still going forward. And now St. Thomas need to get their bodies behind the ball. This is a good try from Royal. Worked it 15 meters already. And now they've pulled it down. And as usual, Vijay Kumar, knowing the penalty is coming, puts it into touch. Or tries to put it into touch. And that's interesting. I mean, why give them the penalty, or why would you not give them the line out there? But I guess opportunity for 3 points is what Roy would want. He'd ask his boot. Pandula de Silva having a little bit of a word with the.
Give it.
You can see the arrowhead formation, beautifully done by Royal, and St. Thomas is eventually having no option but to drag that one down.
Generally, they go like player in school. They got me right. Ambia is not like.
Not sure if I have to necessarily do this talking. I think to happen to this too much.
They
know that here at Royal, I think this thing is just to get on with the game. Then it just slows the game down, doesn't it?
That's right.
I'm going to go to the next one. Under 20 in fact, so.
Blue.
Sri Lanka's number one sports hub, ThePapare.com, brings the Sri Lanka's Premier Club Competition, the Dialogue Champions League,
as 18 clubs battle for supremacy. Live action every Saturday and Sunday, 3:15 p.m. onwards. And there is live action at the Royal College Sports Complex of the Milo President's Trophy. Milo at the forefront of sports coverage here in Sri Lanka, as are the ThePapare and Dialogue TV. St. Thomas has managed to contain that mall. It disintegrates quickly. And booming the striker, calling the mark. But the referee coming back for the penalty. It's a bit of a late call. And another chat. And Panel the same, and now looks like he's going to the bin. Probably a bigger loss than Madurango lost to Roy, because he's the one who throws into the lineout as well. So St. Thomas's will have to defend this rolling ball with their biggest player off the park. You can see what happened there. We'll be able to comment a little further, but that's what the referee is calling. It's in from the side.
So the Royal Challenge decided they're going to ask the same question: how are you going to stop our rolling ball? And so what happens now if it's pulled down again? Is that another yellow card?
Well, the referee's backed himself into a corner, isn't it, Paul? Because if it is defended again exactly the same way, or somebody else comes in from the side, then you're going to have to give the yellow card. Beautiful stretch on there by Manila. And St. Thomas is really attacking by that step. Yes, the referee's really not calling this first step soon enough. And that's what's really coming in. St. Thomas is doing the defense. And that's what this is. Exactly, is it? But it doesn't look like they're going to have to use it, because they're right in the middle of the line.
That
needs to go to the defending side of the defense, because it's a very difficult thing to defend, and the first drive backwards need to be called as a stop, and then you've got to go forward. If you go forward again, that more stops in my book. So the referee's not got that right, because there's no other way for a defending side to attack it.
You're probably right there, Shanikar. I think St. Thomas did really well with a man short, but it's such a well set up rolling ball that it's really difficult to stop as it is.
Yes, it's a beautiful arrowhead formation, isn't it? Once they get formed, there's very little that you can do to splinter them as well. And that's such an important part of the mall, that the front of that arrowhead doesn't allow themselves to be broken apart. And Aski now to put the icing on the cake for Royal. So this is where the little mini battles are won and lost. IS Madurangas sin binning didn't shift any points for Royal, whereas just 1 minute into the period where Pandula De Silva is off, St. Thomas's have already conceded five, maybe seven. And yes, it looks like it is seven. Thank you. I think they're even lucky enough to concede the yellow card. That's a very deliberate round the net. We saw somebody saw it in the yellow card. It's a lot less than that yesterday against St. Peter. And again, St. Thomas has turned it over and conceded 30 meters. So a lot of the game just not going for them today. I think given that Ethan Hayter needs to stop flailing his arms and play the game, if he's not getting the decisions, there's no point in noting about it.
Well, when you've got a player off, the good thing to do is, when you've got a penalty, you've got to do some drills, even if another 30 seconds, and you say, I'm not sure whether I'm going to take a shot at goal, and then maybe take a shot at goal, eat up another minute, and then they come back and it's another 3 minutes gone, and the players don't see it.
So they're without Tour, the lineup, and that's their last two lineups from the attacking position. So it's just so that you lose players in key positions, especially the hookers come up, they look kind of players to the team carriers, and it does impact on the team.
Again, it came from Herat not straightening that line, wasn't it, Paul, when he had the opportunity. He just needed to straighten up, draw that winger in, and then lob it over for Henakan Kanan game. But lots of lateral running. Thomas is struggling, but many opportunities they've had. Roy taking the field that they have. Oh, that's a beautiful drive from Roy. Absolutely brilliant drive. The tight head is picked up by Hamza Reza at the back. And Vijay Kumar puts in the little box kick. It's a smart kick from him. Leon Zalawagina and Leon Kantan and they're patrolling it. And now Zalawagina can try and get away from the shot. Going to ground on his own 5 meter line. Sometimes there's nothing dangerous here. This is Anayaka. Puts the kick in. It's going to go. He's having a kick at the near court. I think just like Nick Hogan and did yesterday, it's probably time for Hans Reiter to warm up on the bench.
Yeah, maybe there's been an example of using the territory, right? They have the ball in the middle of the park, they put a kick out, find some space, and maybe 4 years out of the career. And so,
on the spot. The ball is available and then dive just short. Navaratna with a good tackle, getting his body under the ball there. Some fans is going to be good quickly. Insert short, Roy trying to barrel the ball over the line. Vijay Kumar. Oh, that's a try, is it? No, not yet. Difficult to say how short they are from this angle.
Desperate stuff.
And now they're looking at the other side, changing angles, and Vijay Kumar. And it is a late back. And not letting that Maduranga card affect them so much. They played smartly, and I don't think it's unfair to say that Ashok Vijay Kumar is pretty much running this game.
If you look at that try, it was just the maturity he showed in marshalling the forwards. He didn't panic at any stage, he just kept it, he was directing the forwards, and I think that try is as much as his as it was Mikhail Gunadeva's.
Well, I think it was his kick as well that was put on and put them in that position in the first place, but don't make sure he keeps talking to them, but
Now the ball's going to be coming back to them after this conversion.
Well, this is where they've really got to turn the screws well, not allow St. Thomas's back into this game. As to when again it's good. He's really got this game out in front. A penalty and two conversions as well. He's got made a move to close to the score line. And St. Thomas's now will need to really.
I start each day with a dream to win. Training, working hard, rain, how strong the other team is, nothing can stop me.
Nourishing Milo with its unique combination of chocolate, malted barley and B vitamins, together with the goodness of milk, brings out the winner in you. Milo, fueling the winning spirit.
Nestle, good food, good life.
I start each day with a dream to win. Training, working hard, rain, how strong the other team is, nothing can stop me.
Nourishing Milo with its unique combination of chocolate, malted barley and B vitamins, together with the goodness of milk, brings out the winner in you. Milo, fueling the winning spirit.
Nestle, good food, good life.
ළමය දැන් ඩේටා වලට ඔච්චර ලෝභ වෙන්න ඕන නැහැ. ඔන්න ඩයලොග් හෝම් බ්‍රෝඩ්බෑන්ඩ් එකේ ඩේටා ඩබල් වෙලා.
එහෙනම් ඩබල් ගෙවන්නත් වෙයි.
නෑ, තීන ඩේටා වගේ ඩබල් ලැබෙනව පරණ ගානටම නොමිලේ. ශ්‍රී ලංකාවේ අංකකේ සහ වේගවත්ම ඉන්ටර්නෙට් සම්බන්ධතාවයෙන් දැන් රෑට ඩේටා ඩබල් වෙලා.
ඩේටා ඩබල්.
ඩයලොග් අනාගතය ආදායි.
This is the story of a nation on the move, competing globally through a fiber optic network, delivering solutions instantly with superfast 4G. Redefining entertainment with 3G HSPA Plus, making every day more efficient with Wi-Fi, bringing a world of knowledge to your home with fixed 4G. Get connected to Sri Lanka's fastest network. Dialog, the number one choice of the people. Dialog, the future today. This is the story of a nation on the move, competing globally through a fiber optic network, delivering solutions instantly with superfast 4G, redefining entertainment with 3G HSPA Plus, making every day more efficient with Wi-Fi, bringing a world of knowledge to your home with fixed 4G. Get connected to Sri Lanka's fastest network. Dialog, the number one choice of the people. Dialog, the future today.
Sawadikap, can you give me data sim?
Massage?
No, data sim.
Massage, very good.
No, data sim.
You are Sri Lanka? Why you no use Dialog data roaming? Unlimited data, $5 a day.
Unlimited data for just $5 a day?
Yeah. Unlimited same massage you want?
Me?
Unlimited data roaming for just $5 a day with Dialog roaming. Clearly the best way to roam.
One for one is all I want. One for one is all I need.
Here, what's all this one for one talk?
The one for one plan from Dialog. Get 1 MB free for every 1 minute of talk time. Per second charging and a flat rate to any network.
Dialog, one for one prepaid plan. Dialog, the future today.
Here, how are you going to stay in touch abroad?
Dialog roaming. They give the best rates.
Only if you pick the preferred network. Otherwise...
Just get Dialog roaming. It's the one and only best rate on any overseas network, guaranteed.
One guaranteed best rate on any network? Woohoo!
Hassle-free roaming with the best rates in over 200 countries. With Dialog roaming, clearly the best way to roam.
Introducing the Ultra 99 postpaid package from Dialog. Say everything you want to say with the ultra benefits of extra talk time, extra SMS and extra data at a monthly rental of just 99 rupees only. Dialog, the future today.
Here we are, can I get a data sim? Meh,
I say, old chap, where might a fellow find a data SIM card? Kiannako.
You're from Sri Lanka, right?
How did you know?
Why don't you use Dialog Data Roaming? Unlimited data for $5 a day.
Unlimited data for $5 a day? And
data unlimited, my patience isn't.
Unlimited data roaming for just $5 a day with Dialog Roaming. Clearly the best way to roam.
I start each day with a dream. A dream to win. Training. Working hard. Rain. How strong the other team is, nothing can stop me.
Nourishing Milo with its unique combination of chocolate, malted barley and B vitamins, together with the goodness of milk, brings out the winner in you. Milo, fueling the winning spirit.
Nestle, good food, good life.
It means that now they have to score three times. Or two is small, rather. Instead of just the ones to tie the game up. So there's still 15 minutes to go, so they get to time. And we'll just see what they do here. Are they still going to play this holding onto the ball? Or are they going to start playing some territory? Or it's here they play the ball. And going to the opposite side of the field is Milo. Trying to look at that money, he crosses it now. Well, he doesn't have to because it's lowered nicely in the touch. Doesn't have to take the full control. I think I had some help to turn, he just turned and put the punch on, but Milo makes him feel like
that. That's what I was just about to get up for. That was the second time. I should, whenever he makes the kick, he needs to drop back and cover the space. Because that's the second occasion where he hasn't done that. And you know, roll up back in their own half.
Generally, the number 8 will set up back and cover that. So a 9, an 8, and maybe another back as well. And also, look, if you add it, that's going to come. So I don't know why they're aiming. Nice flat ball, but he left the 15 meter line there. And again, the box kick coming from Vijay Kumar gives it to Mayon Jaiwagan and Sarit Nanayak Kara and the left foot of Jaiwagan. And now Vijay Kumar is back. He's a dangerous man. And he manages to pop it up off the floor into a good support run. Apologies for being off air for just a few moments. We've joined this with St. Thomas's scoring a try. 2-man on Jaiwardena. The conversion missed by Herat, so 5-point replay for St. Thomas's. But the way he's playing soon,
said the lack of form. Yeah, and you see that the better position of the Milo player is in a strong position and close to Thomas's player from the floor out and couldn't move anyone. So that's what I meant that they thought. Looked like the Milo had been on the head of press at the right time, but the referee didn't think so. They've had the final opportunities on Roy to kill this game off. They've got Roy have taken their opportunities where the Athenians haven't. Getting on if it goes up, and again it's untidy ball. Coming in the team back at the back. Here's that good running, but this time I got. Has slowed the ball up a little bit, but so trying to know it has to be said. Dion Dias is having it. And now he's going to be back up. Sending away one tackle. Great numbers to the line out. Breakdown here. Behind Pereira running off the pass. And having Pereira continues to screen him out a little better now. And here's the Silva. Long ball out to Wayne Mack, who's standing in midfield. He needs some help now. Roy really sending their numbers into defense. Doing it beautifully as well. Here they come and get. Christian Roy. Roy might have turned this over beautifully again. Excellent work. The first forward just had right line through there.
Stag and also really put off the hands on that occasion. They had men out wide. Why would you want to go into contact and play into Roy's hands?
Seeing a bit more desperation in the Thomian game at the moment. Roy will need to weather the storm. Well, that's a good win at the lineup. Madi Moran has been excellent in the front of that lineup. Again, that's going sideways. Almost on the back point. Tajidin, great technique at the back. Music says the referee, and now Vijay Kumar hopes he has the penalty. This time he doesn't. The action hammered hard by Vijay Maika and Bilal. And looks like Bilal has done the ball in the ball. Now he needs some support from his mates. Now he seems to have three players at every break. And he smashes through the to bring it out quickly to Fabian Dias. Dias to handle the receiver again. Wrong option. Needed to use the ball with slow pops on the other side. Khalid Hanbaba needed to get it. But the defense too worried about Hena Kantanam. They allowed Hanbaba to run. Not a waste of reaching in the ball. He's knocked up the way down to it. And St. Thomas's clean out is good. That's from the side. Staying at the side of the ball and has to. The ref is back. And staying at the yellow card. Surely it should be. But it isn't. That's a professional foul if I've ever seen one. And again, playing the halfback, Pongo Lodisila. Dying at the time.
twisting and turning and being very strong effort to come on Pereira. He's got enough power to but Roy's defense holds strong. And now bringing the defense America. Here's the switch. Dion Dias. The referee brings it back to the net forward. I don't understand why he didn't give the penalty there. Because there was clearly no advantage coming.
And we got a little more time from the nine. And this guy wasn't the support, the contention spot. Looked like a pretty simple 3 points. They need 3 points and then they need another 7 points. And then they'd won the game. So that was a good 3 points that they turned down. They just let their emotions get carried away with them. You know what that's like when your emotions go and the mathematics go out the window. Well, they need to score 9 points.
No,
they need someone to stand up and take control now at the moment, not let the game run away from them. Sometimes it's still in this, but they need to make sure they're disciplined. Abdullah, as a captain before, what would you say to your team right now?
Paul's last comment that reminded me of Plywood.
As Paul said, you need to keep your emotions in check. The adrenaline is always a good thing, but you've got to use it to your advantage, not to your disadvantage. Christian Delisle, well, making sure they take their time about this. They've been defending for quite a bit.
No,
is having a bit of injury, but there's no way that he's going to go off. Neither is Mahima Dange. Although the 10% that he go off now is pretty consistent by the looks of
things.
Mahima Dange is
it's okay.
On the floor. And they're bringing a stretcher on now.
It's kind of a fun situation. It's interesting to see how Royal can get out from this situation, because it seems to me really to clear their lines from. So you could see probably a number 8 trying to pump it into touch. But they need to be very clinical. If they can just get out from this situation and at least just get into 30 meters away from the try line, I think they've done well. And it'll help them to keep the performance at bay going into the last 5 minutes.
St. Thomas will be shaking their heads, wondering how they didn't score that one. I thought Vijay Kumar will have a fly word into Dion Dias' ear, asking him the same thing: how could he not score that one, mate? Good drive, but again, St. Thomas is going up in the side, but looks like they've managed to come away with the ball well. Good work, 3 at the back. And the penalty, they've got to take the 3 at the ball. They've got to take the 3, surely. Pandula De Silva to Danijay Vijayaratne. Gives the ball, but a little bit too late. Leon Jayawardena, and a good defense on him. Excellent defense there, but slowing the ball down. Dion Dias, Pandula De Silva, now Dumindra Dishanayaka, trying to get through a non-existent gap. Tony Rahangana again smashed in the pit. Excellent defense by Nicky George on the far side. Christian Delisle manages to pluck that ball just in front of him, and Dion Dias now through Teran Pereira, Hanun Patrona. If he says that was okay, it looked a bit clumsy, nothing else. And now, Milan. Not clearing out. Sinit Pereira, I think, who's in the line. Looks like they weren't onside there. And clearly a yellow card has got to come. They got away with one a little while earlier.
In his pocket for the coin on out the card.
And that's a big one for Royal, because there is Madhima on the chief line out jumper. In fact, it's Adnan. And St. Thomas's opting for the short top again. Good defense once again by Royal on the big man, Damage Vijayaratna. Again, lateral running, really not straightening up that. The hunter comes in off the angle. That's a good angle by the prop forward. Gets his team over the line. And now Senanayaka again running into the heavy traffic. They really got to be able to pass this ball. And another second pass. That's a referee. They bring them back for the next forward. They were playing advantage. You can have a cup of tea before he passes the ball at fly half.
Well, such a sort of no St. Thomas players are actually running onto the ball before they collect the ball. So they need to start their running line earlier than when they get the ball. So they catch the ball standing still. Now the defense doesn't really need to come for them or readjust, because they just wait for them, and that's why nothing's happening to them.
They're not playing with any sort of depth in attack on their ball. They're just relying on good power to go through. Sonny Rangama goes off the back. Good tackle by Mabin Aran, the number 6. Good drive by Royal. Spoiling beautifully. That defense has been excellent today. Pandola De Silva needed to get his body position much lower there. And the knock forward has come. And the penalty is there because De Silva held onto the ball again, isolated. And Royal ready to cut each other on the back of the ball because the defense has been stellar today.
It's been a Herculean effort, Shanaka. They have taken extremely big batting from this tournament, but they've stood their ground, and you cannot give more praise to them because it's not easy continuously taking this kind of pressure. They have absorbed it. I think their work over the breakdown has been very good, and the Chromians just haven't been able to rectify that area of the game today.
I think it's been the tournament they lost. They don't contest every single ball. They don't contest every single tackle in a breakdown situation. But the ones that they do decide to go in for, they get more numbers. So it means that defensive line, they've got more defenders than there are attackers.
That's when the defenders try to throw, but you've got to wait for the last team. I don't know where the next breakdown is going to be. There's obviously been a breakdown in communication aspect.
Yes, when you're the attacking team, you obviously know where you're going to try and set up the next phase of play, and St. Thomas have not been ahead of the game in that sense. And it's a very difficult task for St. Thomas to come back into the game from here, but Royal really deserved winners of this game. Vijay Kumar once again in the thick of things. And with the first epic command of action, I don't think we can look any further than the Royal 9 candidate.
He's been outstanding. He's been he's controlled the game magnificently.
Again, the penalty coming for Roy from the side of the referee, and Vijay Kumar looks to have a go. He knows that he's safe now, so he can afford to take a risk or two. Really rubs the leg against Tony and Moon. You can see the Royal players high-fiving each other in the background because they know that this has been a magnificent effort from them in terms of and playing to the strength, playing to the game plan, and the coaches will be really happy with this result.
Yes, sir, and I think if the Thomians look back at this game, they have had many opportunities, but they just haven't been able to make use of that. And also, you really have to question their decision-making at crucial moments. And if you look back at this game, I think the moment where the fortune changed in favor of Royal was when the Thomians lost their skipper to the same game. Royal managed to score 2 tries, but the Thomians have never managed to recover from that.
Yes, it's been the story of that team, isn't it? Mr. in the League Cup final. And now a 2-try blitz again, while there were 14 men down. St. Thomas is not showing the same character that they showed in the league game against Royal or the game against Trinity, where they fought their way back into some 15-point deficits in that Trinity game. But again, as you said, Paul, 3 points at 24-18. So all are going to play with
six men.
Are going to play with added pressure, but St. Thomas didn't even take that option.
I think for me, the St. Thomas's centers have been a little bit. The movement's been a little bit slow. The decision maybe a little bit off today. And I think that's costing as well.
So again, the ball is set. Stop once, there's the referee. And again.
No, nothing there.
No, nothing. Away and driving forward. It looked like it was a truck and trailer there for all money. But now, Steve Royal can really put the last nail into the coffin here with a try from their back. Here's Asen Fernando almost getting through.
Advantage.
Enough forward is coming, so.
He's been very good for Royal this season, Shanaka. You don't have to go much further than that rugby kick that you put to tie the rugby. And but just getting back to the game, I think you have to, while complimenting the Royal, you also have to give it to the defense. I think the way that we put the phone in pressure with a fair amount of discipline, you have to give them a lot of credit. But also, I think the Fornians have only their first to blame, because probably where they had the edge over the Royal team was in that back division. But unfortunately, both the centers seem to be very adamant on going into contact repeatedly and not using their players outwise, especially that back team who are really elusive. And that just played into Royal's hands. And at the end of the day, that I would say, along with that yellow card, was the difference between both teams.
Yes, it was a very interesting performance also by the family in the back division. As Abdullah said, they were favored back division before this game started, but they didn't really ask enough questions from the opposition. And that's Coach Lada getting a handshake from the Royal side, and that's good to see. It's good to see the camaraderie between these two teams as well. Not often that games end in the friendly sort of atmosphere that we're seeing right now. I can see sometimes there's very, very surprising. He becomes the captain of the Sri Lanka 15s and 17s as well. And the power players can be deserted on the line up because sometimes it's really not this game for the tapping. They had some brilliant opportunities when the scrum half goes through and they had a few kicks that went through and they went into the red zone so many times, crossed the ball up and came back ball. And when they go back and watch this video, if they do, perhaps they won't because now their season has ended, but if they do, they will be several things that they will have sleepless nights about.
I'm sure they will have time and their staff will anyway remain humble and see if they get a chance or anything, but really it's a disappointing end for the season for us in terms of the season of tennis during the season, especially the first one where they went for unbeaten. And then still away with nothing in the end. Tampa Rampa really turned out straight as a definite and also this one here. Really, the fortune has changed when the ball stopped playing out for the innings. It started getting stuck with the singles, I feel, and they really went on out from the attacking weapons. And we also had a little bit of pinballs with the third as well. So the fourth out there, they were having the third early on. And I'm starting to become a little bit too complicated for them. So they started the first one really well, and they came to sign, and they came out empty handed. So I think the first yellow had a long backhand kind of night because they look at guys like Johnny Roberts in the center, it's a bit one dimensional, and that's exactly what St. Thomas has lost today. They were just bashing it up the middle, and backhand ball, as they've come to call it, round ball, as they've come to call it, hasn't really worked, and that's what didn't work for St. Thomas as well today. So they take away a season, a successful season relatively from the last couple of seasons that they've had, and they've got all their traditional coaches in their cabinet, so I think overall it will be a season that they can kick off on the positive side. Chris Lava just having a chat to the team. He knows this is his last team talk before we're going to next season's preparations. There will be several of these players back for next season as well. But at the moment, we're on a legend of it, both a pro and St. Peter's and St. Thomas's. We had a lot to learn from the two defeats yesterday and today because both of them had the games, they had the opportunity to put it away. Didn't take it, so that will order him better step for next season.
Yeah, that's right. We can tell you that next season. The start, the playing on first from the start, the sounds like that they've had a little bit of a ground. And see where the strength are, see where the weaknesses are, and see where they can talk about them both of ours. But the team's going to help track it out from the way they played this year. But they started through the season that they can hold their own, they thought they had to learn their roles. Maybe they can look at some other second half and maybe take some picks instead of always taking a quick talk. And the cause of that so far, but I could have taken 4 points and then probably left it up to get the last play of the game and I could stand on the game. But those sort of decisions need to be planned for next season. And they need to be able to put that thing, put them up into the leader's head somehow where they take the right decisions. They need to see that the rest of their world, they call under pressure. And it has the emotional joining match for both teams, for both yesterday and today, I do think that both Mr. Papare and Roy may have just spent themselves a little early into Bingham battle in the final, or I think it might not be as intense as this one. So it's going to get so fairly, isn't it? It'll be the last game of a long season for both teams. I'm sure they'll be up for it. They'll want to throw everything at it. We'll have to probably modify that game slightly when they take on Itapakana because I don't think Itapakana will make the same mistakes that the Tonians did where they will constantly try to run straight at the men. They will probably make an effort to run around the Royal defense as much as possible. So they need to be mindful of that. Royal offensively also, I think we need to be a bit more sharper. Tonians, I think, gave them a few opportunities and let them off the hook on a few occasions. But anyway, I think for the moment, I think both teams will just take a couple of days to sit back. I think we have recovery is going to be closer. I think the PCOs, the backroom staff will be putting a lot of
equipment to talk, because I think the mental and the physical well-being of the 15 or rather the 23 players of both teams is going to be very crucial, and that could very well be the decider, especially after a very long season.
Absolutely, and the first leg of season to me, this first game chapter, our first game chapter on here. Thanks a lot for joining us on the Dialogue TV and the ThePapare.com. The Milo President's Trophy semifinals are done and dusted. This is going to take on the challenges of our college with having some momentum. It's over on their own ground as well, so let's see whether that will add a little bit of spice to the Royals' challenge for the Cup. We'll be back next Saturday with the Milo President's Trophy finals action on both these channels, so make sure you join us then from Paul Tower. Follow us on myself on ThePapare.com and Dialogue TV. Goodbye for now.